everyone, and welcome to this week's Global Business Update with TA. 8,000 jumbo jets, that's right. That's the amount of aircrafts we need to fill with the vials, or what we call the vaccine. If 7.8 billion of the population is to get one dose, they need proper deep freeze facility and GPS-enabled tracking. Is the industry ready for it? Are they on a race to get ready for this kind of delivery? Stay tuned. We will be discussing about that in the upcoming episodes. But for now, the race is on for the cargo flights to get ready for delivering the vaccine to the world. We also see that the MasterCard company is running into a bit of a trouble. A recent partnership with MindGeeks, a seemingly top tech firm, is creating some issues for them, where concerns are being raised why they have partnered with this MindGeeks. Even you might wonder, why such a fuss and a fuss about it? Well, guess what? MindGeeks is actually the parent company of the globally popular, probably the biggest porn platform in the world, Pornhub. So a tie-up between MasterCard and MindGeeks is not seeming to go that or too well for the brand. We also see this year set to be 2020-2021 is the year that is set to be where investments into green energy is going to go above that of traditional energy sources like oil and coal. Well, already some of the top green energy firms are bigger in value than some of the big brands in the industry like Exxon. Good news for the climate change and the green energy enthusiasts over there. After having such a good year with in terms of output, agriculture output, Australia is set to struggle to gain a good value for their exports. Their value of exports to the international market is set to drop by 7%, especially due to some issues they have run into with one of their best and biggest buyers, China. And on a final note, we see there's a question being raised about who owns your PCR data. The human population is getting PCR tests done at a rapid rate. Now, it reveals about your DNA and it reveals so much of confidential private information. But once the test is done, you have control over your DNA data. Can it be sold to marketing companies and so many other different businesses who want to make use of this data to target you for promotions? Even if you don't get a PCR test done, if one of your unknown, unheard of third cousins get a PCR test done, that can trace back to you, and marketers, companies, businesses, governments might be able to get information about you. They say that some research and estimates show that if only about 2% of a population shares or carries out PCR tests, that data, the DNA data from those PCR tests, is enough to get an idea and to do some profiling for the entire population. This is a key question a lot of people need to be asking, though right now we are not. What happens to our PCR data? What happens to the DNA data that is revealed? That is a question that many data privacy advocates and data privacy activists will be concerned about in the coming months. That's it for this week. And no matter what business you are in, stay busy, stay safe, and keep moving.